Hi all, and welcome back to the Beginner's Guide to FlightGear. Today, we'll be taking off into the skies for real, or so I hope. If you don't know what FlightGear is, take a look at the first episode. We'll be using the same setup as last time, the default Cessna 172 and auto coordination on. You ready? Let's hop in. The most important thing to remember is to not oversteer. Try to move the controls smoothly and slowly. That's the secret to flying straight and not going left, right for who knows how long. Tap onto the yoke, then use page up or 9 to advance the throttle to full. You have to steer right just a little bit to keep it from spinning left too fast. At 60 knots, pull the mouse towards you and lift the nose just a little bit into the sky. And we're now in the air. Don't worry if you can't get the plane stable, it does take some practice, and as long as you stay in the sky, I'll consider it a success. Just make sure not to let the speed drop below 60, or things can get hectic rather quickly. Now it is time to show you that the plane does not always go where it's pointing. You see a lot of this later on. I have dragged the throttle down to idle, but I'm keeping the plane level. The nose is still pointing straight ahead, but you can see that the speed is dropping. And if you know where the altimeter is, you can tell I'm descending fast. Then we'll take another look outside and oh my goodness! We're definitely descending this whole time. Thanks for watching Door to Kitty. Next time, we're going to use the altimeter so we can climb controllably and level off at a fixed altitude. We'll see you again next Saturday and have a nice flight.